A house purchased for $110,000 in 1995 is valued at $162,000 in 2008. We want to assume exponential growth and then find the annual growth rate from 1995 to 2008. And then if the value continues to grow by the same rate, what will the house be worth in the year 2012? So to model the value of the house, we'll use the exponential function f of x equals a times b raised to the power of x, where b, the base, is equal to 1 plus r, where r is equal to the exponential growth or decay rate expressed as a decimal. A is the initial amount, or the function value, when x equals 0, and x is the exponent, or in this case, x will be the time in years. So going back up to our given information, since the house was purchased for $110,000 in 1995, we're going to use 1995 as the base year, which means we'll let t equals 0 represent 1995. And this is a common practice when the time is given as a year. So if the house is valued at $110,000 in 1995, we can now say that f of 0 must be equal to $110,000. This is helpful because now we know that a, the initial value, is going to be equal to $110,000. Next, the value of the house is $162,000 in the year 2008. And since 2008 minus 1995 is equal to 13. This is telling us that f of 13 is equal to 162,000. So again, t represents the number of years after 1995. And now for our function, since we're using the variable t for time, f of t must be equal to the initial value, or 110,000, times b raised to the power of t. Notice that when t is equal to 0, the function value would be 110,000 because b to the 0 is equal to 1. And now we can use the second function value to determine the value of b. If f of 13 is equal to 162,000, then f of 13 would be equal to 110,000 times b to the 13th, which must equal 162,000. And now we'll solve this for b to determine our base. So we'll divide both sides by 110,000. So we have b to the 13th is equal to this fraction here. And to solve this for b, we're going to raise both sides to the reciprocal power of 13, which would be 1/13. Remember, when raising powers to powers, we multiply the exponents. 13 times 1/13 is equal to b to the first, or just b. And now we'll find this value here on the calculator. We do need this fraction in parentheses. We raise this to the 1/13th power. Again, the 1/13th will be in parentheses. Rounding to four decimal places, this will be 1.0302. Which means the exponential function that we'll use to determine the value of the house when t is a number of years after 1995 will be f of t equals 110,000 times 1.0302 raised to the power of t. Now to answer this first question, what is the annual growth rate from 1995 to 2008? Remember, the base is equal to 1 plus r, where r is the growth rate expressed as a decimal. So in this case, 1.0302 must equal 1 plus r. So subtracting 1 on both sides of the equation, we have r is equal to 0.0302. Expressed as a decimal, our growth rate is 3.02% per year from 1995 to 2008. And now for the last question, if the value continues to grow by the same rate, what will the house be worth in the year 2012? The first step here is to determine the value of t for the year 2012. Well, t is going to be equal to the desired year of 2012 minus the base year of 1995. So this is going to be equal to 17. So to answer this question, we need to find f of 17, which is equal to 110,000 times 1.0302 raised to the 17th power. We'll go back to the calculator. Raises to the 17th power. We'll go ahead and round to the nearest dollar and say the value is going to be approximately $182,414. But of course, as we all know by now, home prices don't always increase over time. Sometimes they can go down in value, and that's why every model does have its limitations. But based upon the information from this problem, if the trend continues, this would be the approximate value of the house in the year 2012. I hope you found this helpful.